simple true organic. Next is yogurt. I don't have the yogurt that I use, antiviral. It's usually for topical use only. Depending on how clean your dog is, it's not the most important. Hey guys, welcome back to the French Bulldog. My name is Delaney, and today we're talking about home remedies for your Frenchie, or really any dog that you probably have around the house that can help them with a number of different things. And I'm gonna get into them, but before I do, please like, subscribe, and comment down below what content you'd like to see from this channel. We recently just hit 1,000 subscribers, which is absolutely insane. Thank you guys so much for getting me there. I am doing a giveaway soon, so stay tuned for that. And yeah, I mean, I'm so excited to grow the Frenchie fam and for it to be as big as it is so quickly. So thank you. And without further ado, let's get into the video. So today I'm listing 5 things that I've personally used that have worked for Monty. I didn't introduce Monty in this video because he's over there sleeping, and I don't want to wake him up. But these things have worked for him and they've been scientifically proven to work and be healthy for dogs. So the first thing is apple cider vinegar. So I just have the Simple Truth organic apple cider vinegar, unfiltered, and this goes in their water. Normally they're probably not gonna drink it straight because it does have kind of a harsh smell and taste, but I put about a teaspoon in his water, probably no more than twice a week. And having ACV, or apple cider vinegar, in their water helps with digestion, yeast infections, seasonal allergies, and it also supports joint health. So all great things for dogs. So if your dog, put it in their water, see if your dog likes it, because I promise it's a game changer. Next is yogurt, and I don't have the yogurt that I use to give Monty here with me today, but it's usually just a non-fat, plain, it doesn't have a flavor, it doesn't have any added sugar, and yeah, he loves it. He will just eat it right off of a spoon. But this is a good source of calcium for dogs, it's a good probiotic, and it helps with digestion as well. The next home remedy I want to share with you guys is coconut oil. So this I've used numerous times on Monty, especially recently because we have been in Arizona and it's a dry climate, so his nose is constantly cracking and I didn't bring my snout balm with me. So we had to improvise and this has actually worked great. As soon as I put it on his nose, it immediately heals, like it's instantaneous, which is awesome. But other than that, it works for antibacterial, antifungal, and antiviral. It's usually for topical use only. I don't know if coconut oil can be ingested by dogs or if they'd even want to ingest it because it's not, I mean, depending on how picky your dog is, it's not the most pleasing smell, at least in my opinion. Next is pumpkin. Now, a lot of people know of this one. This isn't like a secret one, but pumpkin is used for a lot of things in dogs. Monty gets a scoop of pumpkin every single day, usually right before bed because he does have some acid reflux problems. If he doesn't have anything in his stomach for probably 10 or more hours, he does tend to kind of throw up a creamy white liquid. I know that sounds so gross, but it's common in Frenchies. So we give him a tablespoon of pumpkin every night around 10, 11 o'clock when we go to bed. It is crucial that you use the 100% pure pumpkin and not like a pumpkin pie filling because that has a lot of added sugar and stuff. So this one is just a big can of pumpkin. Other than helping Monty with his acid reflux, pumpkin is also good to ease constipation. It's rich in vitamins and antioxidants, and it's a great fiber source to keep them full. The fifth and final thing that I'm going to mention in this video for home remedies is an oatmeal bath. So basically you're just going to take regular old-fashioned oats, put them in water to create an oatmeal bath for your dog. And this is going to be if your dog is very itchy, seasonal allergies, something like that could affect kind of their skin and how flaky and itchy it is. But if you put them in an oatmeal bath, they're less likely to be itchy and it is really good for them. It's really good for babies too. So usually if you can give it to babies, you can give it to puppies as well. So that's just a good rule of thumb. I want to thank you guys for watching this video. Tune into the next one and I'll see you guys then. Bye guys.